As we all know, Messi, the world's top footballer, today rage quit. Are you surprised?
It's not rage quit as much as sorrow quit. He's weeping like a child.
But yes, we are shocked kind of.
Yeah, we're shocked. Yeah.
Then again, you don't associate Messi with international teams so much.
We associate Messi with club football. It's the opposite for Indians because it's like an Indian cricketer quitting an IPL team. It doesn't really have the same impact, right? Because
that's
you associate
right.
Indian cricketers with India. You don't associate them with IPL teams. It's like the opposite for Messi.
So talking about crying, internet has been flooded with memes of Messi crying. But he's not the only sports person who's cried on the field or any such occasion. Who's your favorite crying sports person?
So many of them. Everyone's cried. Like, you got like at least three guys I can think of in India. You got Kapil Dev, you got Kambli, you got Srishant. Srishant was good. Kambli was better.
Between Srishant and Kapil Dev?
Kambli, because his thing was related to performance on field.
But between Srishant and Kapil Dev?
I don't know, it's too much of a...
Yeah, I think there'll be a toss-up.
Yeah.
But none of them actually quit and cried.
Yeah. Although it seems like a logical thing to do. Usually you make like silly decisions after when you're weeping and you make like emotional decisions.
I think Federer should take the cake for me.
Yeah.
You know, he looks so graceful while playing, doing everything which he does on court. And then he suddenly breaks down.
And then he did it again. And then he did it again after that. Like, first time was surprising.
And the worst was when, in one tournament, he did not win, Nadal won, and he cried.
Yeah. But Nadal crying was probably even worse than... Worse means stranger than Federer crying. Federer was sort of, like, genteel. You expect him at some point.
True.
His emotions will break, he will give way. Nadal, you don't expect him to cry. He's like this ferocious...
Huge biceps.
Yeah. You don't expect muscle guys to cry.
Yeah, muscle probably.
Yeah.
It's not like Andy Murray, even though he has muscle.
Yeah.
But that's perpetually crying.
Yeah. Well, that's a British thing, I guess. Maybe.
But what's the big deal about Messi quitting international cricket? I mean, compare it to the club football that he plays? I mean, is it really a big deal?
The thing is that Messi gets most of his money from club football, most of his acclaim, his love that he gets all over the world. It's from club football, it doesn't come from... him playing for Argentina.
How much money does he make?
36 million euros a year by playing for Barcelona.
So Johnny, you'll also quit, no? If you made like 36 million.
I'd quit if I made a tenth of that.
I'll also quit. Yeah. I'll beg, borrow and steal from Johnny.
It makes the quitting a lot easier, I suppose.
You know, in club football, you get everything. You play around the year. A team is built ground up for you if you are Messi or Cristiano Ronaldo.
It's built around you.
He seems like a complete misfit in the international team. It's like the other players don't seem to know how to play with Messi.
Yeah, that's true. It's a particular problem with actually Latin American teams because most of their players are playing in Europe for different teams. Higuain is playing for Napoli. Then you have Kun Aguero, he's playing for City. And then these guys, they come together and then they start playing for Argentina. And because they are individually such big names, you always expect Argentina to win. And they have the best player in the world.
Yeah.
But the thing is that the team is not built around that best player in the world.
Yeah, the team is built around who they got. And so you got like a few guys who are playing in Europe, like the best guys playing in Europe, and then you got like a bunch of guys playing in the Argentinian league.
Not the same pressure that Ronaldo has for Portugal.
Yeah, because you don't expect Portugal to win. You expect Argentina to win.
Actually, because Portugal's best performance in global football competitions has been their semi-final appearance when Eusebio was there half a century back.
And in fact, it's the fourth time Argentina has lost in the finals, right?
Yeah, fourth time in the last 9 years and thrice in the last 2 years. Including World Cup final.
So considering the money, considering how the team doesn't quite gel, are you still surprised that Messi quit?
You kind of get why he quit.
Yeah.
It doesn't stop being funny. Still funny.
But I don't think that it's permanent.
Oh, that's interesting.
Yeah.
Do you think he's going to come back?
I think that he probably will come back because as Johnny said, it's a spur of the moment decision. It's a sorrow quitting. Sergio Romero, the goalkeeper, he also said that it was probably Messi is going to revisit his decision. One of the other problems that is happening is that, you know, Argentina's federation, it's teetering on the brink of collapse and they just could not even book their flight tickets for the final. So that was one of the things that, you know, terribly upset Messi.
Yeah, why would you want to play for...
So why do you want to play for such a team in such a mess?
But to be fair, like this, it's good to see some amount of honest sorrow on a football field.
Alright, so you can possibly tell us about your favourite meme that you've seen today. Messi quitting, crying, etc.
I think Messi's face being supplanted by Michael Jordan.
Yeah, because he's the original sorrowful athlete. There's also one, like, because apparently Maradona told the team, Argentinian team, don't come home if you don't win the trophy. So Messi's apparently crying because he's not going home anytime. He's not going to go back home. Not happening.
Okay, thank you so much, guys. Thanks for your time.